Fashion be late, yeah. I'm last in, I play the cards.
Hey guys, it's Molly. Today I'm gonna be filming a like kind of must-haves for all of my makeup. I'm just gonna like go through face, cheek, lip, eyes, whatever else I missed, and say like what I think, not even beginners, but people who are just like overwhelmed in Sephora or a drugstore and don't know what to buy, because there are so many options. So I figured I would go through and just say like a couple options for each part of the face that's a must-have for me. And I hope that this will be like really helpful for a lot of people who are overwhelmed like me and just need a little bit of guidance. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so starting off with face, I have two different options because one's like a lot more coverage and one is a lot less. The first one that I have as an option is the Revlon ColorStay 24 Hour, which I'm sure you've heard about because literally everyone and their mother uses this foundation. But I figured I would show it to you guys still just because it is such a good foundation and it's only about $8. And I think that for if you're starting out and you don't know what foundation to get, this is definitely the one to get against the Revlon ColorStay. And I think mine's in the lightest shade, and it just gives such great coverage, and it really like gives high quality coverage for only $9, so this is definitely a must-have. The other foundation option that I have is also by Revlon, and it is the Revlon Nearly Naked Foundation, and I thought that it broke me out, but it really doesn't. I think it was just like, I don't know, something was going on with my face, but it doesn't actually break me out. It's a great foundation. This is more of a BB cream, even though it says it is a foundation. I would consider this more so a BB cream because it doesn't give as much coverage, and it feels very light on your skin, so if you're looking for something like that, I would recommend the Nearly Naked Foundation. Okay, so next going into like powder and stuff like that, I only have one recommendation, and it's just because this is such a good product, I feel like you can't go wrong with it. I feel like every girl should have this in their makeup collection, and it is the MAC MSF or Mineralized Skin Finish. Mine is in Light Plus. It just looks like this. It's just a nice powder, and I feel like it doesn't go on cakey at all, and it just looks very natural on your skin. And really, like, everyone has these, but they are such a good product, and I think that you would not be disappointed with this at all. Okay, so next I have cheek products, and I have two, and they're both high-end, but I feel like one of them is definitely much more affordable than the other. The one that I think is more affordable is the MAC blushes. This one that I have right here is in Pink Swoon. It just looks like this. I've hit pan on it pretty badly. But I really just think that these are so pigmented and they're really worth the money, and they aren't nearly as expensive as a lot of blushes at Sephora. I think this was $15, which really isn't that bad for a blush. The other blush option I have is NARS blushes, and these blushes are just amazing. This one is in Deep Throat, awkward, but all the blush names are like that, but they are just such great blushes, and they give you so much product, and they're so pigmented, but they still look natural on your face, and yeah, I think that basically everyone loves these. I've never really heard anyone say that they don't like a NARS blush, and if you're willing to spend the money, I think this was, I think it's like 28, it's either 28 or 32, it's one of those, and if you're willing to spend the money, it's not that bad, but it is a little bit crazy for just a blush, then I would definitely recommend getting the NARS blushes in any shade. They're really all beautiful. Okay, so one thing that I should have mentioned at the beginning, but whatever, I'll mention them now, is brushes, and this was my, like, one of my first set of brushes that I ever got, and it is the Stila brush kit, and I think it's just 5 brushes, and comes with an eyeliner, an eyeshadow, a foundation brush, a concealer brush, and a blush or like powder brush. I use this one for blush. But I just love all of these brushes, and I think that you need a set of brushes. And this kit, like all these brushes, which are really good quality, they don't shed at all. Like my MAC brushes, they shed a ton, but these ones do not shed at all. And I think this whole pack was $25. I did get it around Christmas time, like a year ago, but like you can still find really great deals online for brush kits, and you don't really need 40 brushes for your first kit. I think that you just need the basics, and then you can add on like more brushes as you get your collection bigger. Okay, so next I'm moving into eyeshadows, and for eyeshadows I only have one recommendation, and it's just because I think that judging by the name, it's just a basic that you need to have in your collection, and if you're just starting out, these colors are amazing to use, and they're just so perfect for everyday use. You can change them from day to night so easily, and having just these colors can get you through a year without needing to buy any other eyeshadow. Probably guessed it. It is the Naked Urban Decay Basics palette, and it's so tiny. It's great for travel. Like, here's my palm of my hand, and it fits like that, just as a reference. But these are what the colors look like. There are six colors in here, six shades, and they're just really, really pretty shades, and I think that they're so versatile for so many looks, so I would definitely recommend this. And I think this was only $32, which is a steal for Urban Decay products because they're just such high quality, and I definitely recommend it. Okay, so next I'm moving into eyeliner, and I have two recommendations just depending on your preference of what kind of eyeliner you like to use. The first is my all-time favorite eyeliner. I just love this eyeliner so much. It is the Maybelline Master Precise Eyeliner, and it's like the pen type one. I just got a new one, but this eyeliner is literally amazing. I promise that it will not let you down, and yeah, I really don't have too much else to say about it. It's just a great eyeliner, and it's so precise, so you really don't have, if you're like bad at putting on eyeliner, which I am terrible at, you really don't have to worry about making mistakes because it's just so small and it's perfect. The next eyeliner option that I have is the, it's also by Maybelline, it's the Maybelline Eye Studio Gel Liner, and it comes in like a little gel, you know, container like that. It also comes with the like pen type, not pen, brush thing. I don't really use this, I use my eyeliner brush, but it does come with a brush if you do not own a eyeliner brush yourself. Definitely a great product, and I think it's only like $9 at the drugstore, so you should pick this up if you like gel eyeliners. Next is my favorite part of the face, which is mascara, and I just feel like mascara is such a great thing because you can change it up so much and you can learn from your mistakes of what mascaras you like and what you don't, and they're not really that expensive. Just in general, I would recommend the Maybelline mascaras, but my three favorite mascaras are this yellow, blue, and red one, and the red one is the 1x1. This one is if you want like really separated lashes and they're long and beautiful. The Rocket Mascara, which I love this thing. I think everyone loves this one. It's generally new. I love the packaging, which isn't really that great like to say just because it's packaging, but I love this thing. It gives such great volume, and yeah, this one is awesome. It's great for layering with other mascaras. And then the last one is the Colossal Volume Express Mascara, and it's in yellow packaging with purple, and I love this one too. This one is more if you want a like really long eyelashes. This one, I use this one when I go out with my friends all the time, and it makes my eyelashes look very like fake-esque, if that made sense. Okay, so lastly, moving on to lips, I have two recommendations, really three, but I only have two of them with me right now. The first recommendation I would have is lipsticks. If you like lipsticks, I recommend either the Revlon lip butters, which I don't have with me right now, they're upstairs and I don't feel like going to get them, but those are just amazing all around. I'm sure you've heard about them because everyone here on YouTube loves them, and me included. And then the other lip products that is kind of goes along with the lipsticks is the new line from Maybelline, the Color Whispers, or Whispers. But yeah, these are, I only have two of them, and this one is in One Size Fits Pearl, and it looks like this, and this one has a little bit of shimmer in it, and I love these, guys. This one is my, like, all-time favorite lipstick right now, just because it tastes like, what's it called? A creamsicle. That's exactly what it tastes like on your lips, and it gives such great color, and they're so moisturizing. They're just like the Revlon lip butters, but they have a lot of different shades. So I would either recommend the Revlon lip butters or the Color Whispers. So if you're younger than me and you aren't really into lipstick right now, I would definitely recommend the Maybelline Baby Lips. I have three right here in Peach Kiss, in Pink Punch, and Grapevine, and I love all three shades. I think that they come in a lot of different shades, the baby lips do. They have like, I think they have like, what is it, 15 shades? I don't know how many they have. I don't own all of them, but I know some people that do, and they come in a lot of different shades, and they look like really intimidating right now, but I promise they're like not at all. They come off very sheer, which is really good if you're doing like an everyday to school. Okay guys, so that is everything for my must-haves. I hope that you enjoyed it and that it was a little bit helpful for those of you who Don't really know what to get yet for makeup wise. I just have a couple things to say. The first is make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos. The second is if you could please comment down below what you want my next video to be about, because again, I would love to do something that you want. The third is if you have a Twitter, I will link my Twitter somewhere right here and in the down bar. It is MissMollyAnn14. I've been tweeting a lot from that account lately, and I would love if some of you would follow me on it, just because you can keep up with me a lot more, because I only upload on here every other day. The thing I have to say is if you have an Instagram, I'll also put my Instagram name right here. It's Molly Bales. It would mean the world to me if you would follow me on it, and like, if you comment on this video your Instagram and you follow me on it, then I will follow you back on Instagram, because I would love to keep up with some of you as well. Okay guys, so that's it. Thank you again for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.